When the first Ford Model T hit the road 115 years ago, it cost about $800, and it had a top speed of 40 miles an hour.
Of course, cars have evolved over the years, and in today's Behind the Wheel, Tony says the best place to see that change is right in front of you.
If the face of a car is its front grille, then its heart and soul is the dashboard.
The dashboard is where car and driver meet, touch, and communicate.
Gas gauge, speedometer, odometer, amp gauge, and your dash lights.
In 1928, that's all a dashboard really needed.
The dashboards in those were so simplistic.
But over time, cars became more elaborate, from their tail fins to their turn signals.
You have a throttle lever that you can pull, and it'll lock the throttle in place. Kind of an early style cruise control. This is the aerial adjuster, and then you've got your dial.
Inevitably, competition between automakers drove dashboard innovation.
It was a competitive race back then to who's got the most shock factor of looks.
By the time World War II was over, Americans were ready for a little luxury. Car makers filled that need with elegance for the masses.
Oh, definitely the 40s and 50s. The late 40s post-war cars, their dashes are just awesome.
Yeah.
Lots of chrome, neat gauges. You get your kind of jukebox style dashboards with the radio and the speakers, and they really became ornate instead of just practical.
And if you think AM radios were the only entertainment behind the wheel in those days, think again. This 1956 DeSoto came with an optional turntable. That's right, a turntable mounted in the dash.
Slide it back in, close the door.
The road-ready record player may not have stood the test of time, but design cues like the wraparound dash in this 55 Thunderbird that surround the driver and immerse them in the car definitely have.
It's all about the just feel and the excitement of being behind the wheel of that car with all that new modern uniqueness.
Comparing the Ford Mustang dash from 1968 to 1996 to 2022, it's clear that the dashboard continues to evolve, and it's currently taking its cues from technology.
It's all touchscreen and whatnot. It's today's modern, everything's got to be technologically advanced.
So it looks like in-dash touchscreens are here to stay, which is more than we can say for ashtrays, cigarette lighters, and the turntable. I'm Tony Martinez, Fox 12 Oregon.
When the story was running, we were kind of discussing when you might use the turntable.
Right.
And the phrase, making out, was tossed around.
Use it when you make out. You probably can't, you know, be driving.
Not
with
so
the,
much. But,
you know,
we should point out, that's how we personalized music back then. And then you went to the 8-track eventually,
right.
And then the cassette and so on.
CD player. Okay, but they were so beautiful.
Yes.
I mean, you know, you do, the technology is great, but you see these old dashboards and they're gorgeous.
It was the design, and they really reflected, like, there was Art Deco during the Art Deco time, and there was, like, you know, once sort of got their cues from like jet fighters with the fins and so forth.
Right.
So it really reflected the era. But one thing that I didn't know before and I found out was that dashboard actually was a piece of wood when they had horse-drawn wagons to keep the person from getting mud dashed up on them.
Oh my
And it literally was a board that was a dashboard.
Yep. Huh. That is
borrowed
cool.
The term. Yeah. Do they still have them on buggies now?
I haven't ridden in a buggy lately, but you do see them.
Kim doesn't throw the record. She doesn't drive a buggy to work every day.
Because her first car was a buggy. We all know that. She knew what I meant.
Such a fun piece. I really liked it.
I loved it.
I was wondering if Kim's comment in between the segment would make it on air. So
I did. First thing that came to mind.
Yeah, totally. All right.